Hi, and thank you for joining us tonight on our show, Dog is Family, where we celebrate the bond between people and their dogs, where we explore the emotional, physical, and all kinds of ways to enjoy and enhance the bond you have with your dogs. And tonight is a very special night. We are talking about some of the holiday topics, so we hope you'll join us for all of the things that we want to cover with you. First, to my right, I would like to introduce my guest, who you probably know by now, Miss Denise Lacey. Mrs. Denise Lacey.
Hi, Barb.
Hi,
Denise.
Glad to
be here again.
I'm glad you are. My name is Barb Emmett. I am your host for the rest of this half hour. I am a certified dog lover, a dog mom to two golden retrievers, Lake and Charlie, and I'm also the proprietor of Godfrey's Welcome to Dogdom. So again, thanks for being with us around Berks County. We've had a little bit of snow, so we're here and we're raring to go. The first topic again is Let's Talk Turkey.
You're on mute. Sorry, you're on mute.
That's okay.
Keep going, you're good.
The first topic tonight is Let's Talk Turkey. The reason that we're going to be covering this is that there's proteins that many of you might not have thought about for feeding your dogs. And of course, it's Thanksgiving and it's time to think about our own turkey dinners. I don't know about you, Denise, but I just can't wait for that turkey dinner. It's one of my favorites.
I'm glad my husband cooks the turkey.
Aren't you very lucky?
I just have to make the dishes that go with it.
Oh, that's lovely. Well, that's wonderful. Turkey is a great protein for dogs. I don't know, again, how much you know about what's going on in the market and the dog food market, but as we've talked about in previous shows, we like to cover what's good, better, and best in dog foods and treats, and there's some exciting things going on. This product I was introduced to recently, and it's the actual complete turkey dinner. And I gotta tell you, if you open this bag, and we're gonna test this, what you have to do is mix it with warm water. It is a freeze-dried product. I fed it to my dogs, and it's just a beautiful product. It does mimic the whole turkey dinner. What you're going to see there is what they do is take a raw turkey product, just the breast meat. They actually then freeze it to a point where it needs to be frozen, and then the water is taken out of that product. But you can actually see all your ingredients, their whole ingredients. This is obviously made in the USA. It is made by a private company, Bravo. And you've got the turkey, the green beans, you can see the cranberry, and it mixed up, it smells incredible. I really wanted to eat that product myself. I can't even tell you how good this is. You need to know that there are fantastic products out there for our dogs and food. So I wanted to introduce you to that. When we start talking turkey, here's something else that if Tilly could smell this, she would go bananas. This product is made in Lancaster County, and it is smoked turkey. Now, when we open this, I had my dog salivating over this, Charlie. He just couldn't even stop thinking about this product. And it is a wonderful, just turkey filet. That's all it is, smoked turkey, naturally smoked. Look at this one, Denise.
I like their products, too. That's the Wild Meadows, right?
Yes, yep. Wild good Meadows stuff. Products. Good stuff
good,
from Lancaster.
Good training stuff.
It is. It smells so good. It's from the turkey tender. And you can feel very comfortable feeding something like this. It's really a cool product when we talk turkey. Another product that I think is exciting as well is by a company called Sojo's, and it's simply turkey raw freeze-dried meat treat. And again, when you look at the back of this bag, the only ingredient in this product is turkey. That's it. There's nothing else. There's no other preservatives, flavorings, or colorings. And when you read labels, you will definitely see the difference when you're looking at something like this type of product, than what you're going to find in a general treat aisle. So again, simply turkey, that's all it is. Great training treat, great treat for them to have to get excited about their food in case they might be a little finicky eater. Another product we talked about, Wild Meadows, also has a turkey jerky in a square form. Again, another beautiful product. And then when we start looking at some of the canned foods on the market today, you got to really get excited, to be honest. Turkey with cranberries and apples. Beautiful product. When you open this, again, it's lovely. It is made with turkey and turkey liver and the apples and the cranberries. and it has a snap pop lid, which makes it very easy for you to serve to your pups. There is an organic turkey dinner, which is coming complete with the turkey and the carrots and the potato. It is certified USDA organic. So that takes quite an effort to get certified in the product itself for the USDA seal. And another product is, again, the pumpkin that you would want to think about giving your puppy through Thanksgiving dinner, again, is made of organic pumpkin. So there are plenty of things to be feeding them when you're thinking about Let's Talk Turkey for Thanksgiving dinner, right? It's making me get a little bit hungry.
Absolutely.
What I'd like to do is turn to our slides now as we think about is our Thanksgiving dinner theirs too. What can you feed and what can you stay away from? If you're cooking your dinner at home or someone's trying to give you a plate for leftovers, some of us sometimes want to think about giving it to their dogs. So yeah, let's see what is, I just wanted to give this as a true reminder of the things that you can feed your dogs. And I see that now those blocks might not be, are they coming up? The things that you can give are obviously the turkey, but you'd have to give the turkey without the skin, without gravy. You should select the white meats and you should select a very small portion. The next thing you can give them from your own Thanksgiving dinner is sweet potatoes, but you don't give them after you've added that marshmallow and after you've added the sugar. But certainly nothing with extras in it, no sugars, no nuts, no butter, but sweet potatoes are good for them, great fiber. Another thing is dried cranberries. Simply dried cranberries, a little bit, mind you, just like a little handful. No sugars added in those cranberries. And the last thing that you might want to think about is pumpkin and squash. And feed only the cubes you use before making your pies or your soups. You can just feed them the way they are. Now let's look at the no-nos again. We all need a little bit of a reminder because when you're cooking and you're moving around that kitchen and something falls on the floor or you think, oh, I'm going to give them this, it has something in it, you might not be thinking of all the ingredients. But just as a quick refresher, no onions, no natural bones from those turkeys, no sage, nutmeg, no dough or cake batter, macadamia nuts or walnuts. Stay away from those. Now, any of the other vegetables you might be preparing, I say before glamming those things up for the rest of your guests who may need all kinds of extras added to those vegetables, certainly give them the vegetables in their pure form. Green beans, the carrots, the broccoli, but certainly you can give them a little bit of that Thanksgiving dinner. You just want to be sure that your other family members aren't slipping them something else. And then the last thing I want to talk about is there is an event that is at Godfrey's that is a Thanksgiving Wine and Dine Fest. And it is on November 22nd, and it is from 10 to 4 p.m. at Godfrey's, and we'll be also at that event. Mostly Mutt's Rescue will be there, and they will have a dog or two up for adoption. I understand that they did have some puppies coming in. So it is a free event for you to come out with your dog. It's a way of saying thank you to the dogs that make our lives as dog as family much better. So it's the way to just say thanks, share a little turkey dinner for the dogs. And any donations to Mostly Mutts is very much appreciated. So I did want to remind folks to come on out, see some of these, and have your dog taste some of these wonderful products, and have some fun doing it and saying thanks. So that's the presentation on turkey dinners and Thanksgiving and turkey itself as a protein, easily digestible.
Excellent. Yep. You mentioned some no-nos.
Yes.
Feeding dogs, and I always like to throw out there because I'm still finding people that don't know.
Grapes.
To really watch out for, well, grapes and raisins. Absolutely.
Grapes and raisins,
if they go
yep.
to stuffing.
That should be
but
on there.
Xylitol.
Yes.
It's a sweetener. More and more people are having things that gum, candy, but even other foods that it's in, and it's highly toxic to your dog. So make sure that if you've got somebody tossing things to the dogs that you know what's in them, because I'm still surprised the number of people that are not aware of this highly toxic thing
that is a
sugar replacement for people and fine for us, but not good for our pets.
Thank you for that. Yeah, people don't realize that if they're cooking or making things with that, you need to know. So thank you. The next topic we have coming up is one that Denise is going to be covering and has to do with some training issues to make life better at home. Denise, I'll give it to you.
Okay, so we're going to talk about mat work. I have a picture here of my Schipperke, who you'll meet in a minute, being a good girl at home and sitting on her mat while my husband's at the kitchen table. And hopefully she'll behave herself when she comes out later. But I did bring photographic proof that she can do what she's supposed to be doing. So the reason that we want to talk about mat work tonight, this gives us a great way to give our dogs something to do when we need them to behave. It's an activity that they can be doing. So this is the beginning steps of it, demonstrated by Payden with his mom, Dee Dee. She's building value for the mat for him. If he's staying on the mat, that's where the cookies are showing up, and she's moving around. Here is Tegan and her mom, Jen. Tegan's a flat-coated retriever. Jen's working with moving around as a distraction, building some more distance, but you'll see she still comes in and rewards the treat on the mat. Now, she's going to start tossing the treat away from the mat so that Tegan goes to get the cookie, and we're looking to see, does she know the mat's the place to be? Yes, she's coming back to the mat to hang out again, and mom's treating her for that. That's an important piece to see, that your dog starts to understand when you're doing mat work, that they understand, yeah, it's this place that I'm supposed to go hang out. Now Jen's working with some distractions, sitting down, making sure that Tegan understands, yeah, even when I sit down, you gotta stay there. Here's Joker, a Pomeranian, with his mom, Sheila, and they're working on distance with their mat, and he's going far away. He's going about 30 feet away from mom to that mat, and we're working on that he can reliably be sent at a distance to his mat. So we're working on our mat. We want to build value for the mat. We want to add duration to the time our dog spends on it. We're going to introduce distractions. That's moving around, sitting down. We're going to add distance, and then we're going to keep practicing. Our goal, ultimately, is to use this with having meals, sitting and watching TV, guests are over to visit, any of these things. So I'm going to bring out my buddy Tilly here, and we will do a little bit of demonstration here with the beginning of mat work. Tilly is a 5.5-year-old Schipperke. Who I jokingly call my no-no bad dog. She's very, you can see, she goes, the mat. Can you go mat? Tilly, can you get on your mat? Yes, good girl. So when you start working mat work with your dog, the first thing you're going to do is just reward them for being on it. If they already know how to do a down, you can ask them to do a down before you reinforce. But you'll see right now, what I'm doing with Tilly, she doesn't mind demonstrating these early steps because it gets her lots of cookies. You're just helping your dog understand. Hanging out on the mat can get you lots of good treats. You're going to slowly look for more duration for the behavior. You're going to have them hanging out and waiting a little bit longer before they get the treat. Tilly says, like this game. And so as we build this reinforcement, what you saw in the video was the people moving around with their dogs. They're moving back and forth. They're making sure that the dog understands that. Before you move to that step, you want to make sure that your dog is just willing to comfortably hang out here, okay? Now, when you're working on this for meal times, when you first start this, to expect your dog to go hang out on the mat while you sit at the kitchen table for 15, 20 minutes to eat your meal with no reinforcement is not realistic. They're not going to understand that they're supposed to do it that long. You're sitting at the table with lots of food. They're going to be looking for, hey, let's come hang out underneath the kitchen table where somebody always drops me something. So what we're looking for is when you start working this, Tilly, right now, she's like, hey, the cookies are in your hand. Can you go mat? Good. Get on your mat. All right. So we start working from the table. What we're looking for is to have our dog get cookies tossed to them. And so we'll see if Tilly and I can demonstrate this. Tilly, go mat. Down. And so I can toss her a cookie over there and ask her to go mat. Oh, she knows where all the other cookies are. Go mat. Go mat. Go mat. Good. Go mat. Yes, good girl. As you can tell, the mat's sliding all over the place, but she's still trying to make it to the place she's supposed to be. And she's ignoring a distraction of majorly delicious salmon cookies over here on top of her crate. So when you're working from the table, when you start adding that piece, don't be afraid to have a little dish on the table with yourself with some treats in it for your dog, so that as you're eating at the dinner table,
If they're hanging out on the mat, you can mark that and toss the treat over to them on the mat so that they're still getting reinforcement. You saw in the video with Tegan the flat coat, when her mom tossed a cookie and it didn't land on the mat, she knew to put herself right back on the mat. She had had enough reinforcement for that, that she knew that was the place to hang out. So what you're looking for is, even if your aim is not great and the cookie goes bouncing around, once your dog gets that cookie, that they go park themselves back on the mat again so that you can continue reinforcing. In the course of a meal, 15, 20 minutes, you may toss them 20 or 30 treats, but that way they're getting information on what they're supposed to do, they're learning how to be successful, and over time, you're not going to have to continue tossing them food throughout the meal. What you'll end up with is a dog that goes, I know when my family sits down at the dinner table, if I go and lay on my mat, I'm going to get something at some point in time. You can toss them a cookie at the end. You can give them a chance to lick the plates if you like to do that. But you're looking for them to hang out at that mat during your mealtime. Same thing with if you're using it for when guests are there the first few times. Until your dog really understands the behavior, you're still tossing the treats to them on the mat while they're doing the good behavior every minute or two. But then once they start to get the idea of what the behavior is, you're looking to give them the cue. They go hang out on the mat. You don't have to have something fancy. Tilly inherited that from my previous Skipper Key. It's really nice to train this with a hand towel because it's something easy to throw in your bag when you're traveling. No matter where you go, it gives you a way to let your dog know, hey, hang out in this location. We're happy if you are there. The dog has something to choose to do instead of going, what am I supposed to do? Do I jump in your lap? Do I run around the room? Do I steal things to get your attention? They've learned that they can earn your attention by just hanging out calmly on their mat. And you can see that Tilly is excited about the snow. I was telling Barb before we came in. We went for a walk before coming, and she was zoom, zoom, zoom all over the place. It's cold. It's snowing. So I don't know about your dogs, but anytime the weather changes, cold or when we hit spring, woo, we get a little crazy.
Oh, yeah, our boys love the cold as well. Okay.
Yep. All right. Well, thanks for that. We certainly understand that the applications of Go to Mat and how many times people would love to have that skill at home with their dogs, because there's certainly many stories of begging at the table. My personal story is that our previous Goldens were trained not to sit by the table. They would lay at a certain place in the kitchen until Grandpop came to live with us for a period of time. And then Grandpop would slide food under the table. And from that point on, we never got back that go-to place command. So, yeah. But it is really, really helpful.
Yeah. And you can do it without a mat. If you have a certain,
they had a
just
place.
What you just said, you have a place. And if they know that that place is where the treats are going to show up, they learn to hang out there. If they learn that the better stuff is coming under the table from Grandpa, it kind of wrecks that training.
It kind of did really wreck it, and we just never got it back. And, of course, Grandpa wouldn't admit it either. So
I
think hopefully you folks can start thinking about training in that way, a very simple process that Denise has kind of laid out step by step. Yeah. And you just have to have very nice high-value treats going on. That leads us to our next topic, which is stress busters for the holiday. One of the things would be to have your dog at a place that they feel comfortable when you ask them to go there. With stress busters, there's some other things that I don't know are well known out there, but they're very natural products that can really kind of take the edge off in situations where you might need that for your dog. One of the things on the market is this Adaptil, which is a pheromone appeasing product. Pheromones are what the mother dog emits in a hormone. And they've created a synthetic version of this that can be used as an air diffuser or on a collar around your dog, which you'd replace every 30 days or so. This is typically only available through your veterinarian. But we have definitely good feedback. One of the girls that I know, she uses it on her mother's dog, Chloe, and it really takes the edge off. So it's a natural product that you can think about trying, and you can talk to your vet about that. On the market, there's a wonderful application of bat box flower essences. This is by a company called Botanical Animal. And what it is are formulations from flower essences, all natural. They do not contraindicate with any kind of medication that your dog may be on. And it's simply putting drops on a treat, or maybe some folks like to put it in the water. I like to get all the drops in them at one time to take the edge off. And there are formulations for all kinds of things. This one's called Devil Be Gone. You can really help folks with this if there's certain behavioral patterns that you're seeing. One of them is Mellow Out, the most popular one. And sibling rivalry is another one if you're having some conflicts in the home. It's a way for behavior modification naturally. And then there are some bones. Terrabone has a great product with some calming herbs in it. There are these other calming treats from Pet Naturals with, again, herbs. Only 2 treats a day, and especially during the holidays or when the company is coming and you want to have something for your dog to take that little bit of edge off. And again, things like the Thunder Shirt or the Anxiety Wrap. That might be in more specific situations when you're traveling and you've got something else going on. But another one here is a wonderful product called Itching for Nirvana, and that is to calm the dog down. And there are some Chinese herb blends, Calm Shen from the Herbsmith Company. So again, natural things that you can really see the difference in your dog if you start using them and you're consciously thinking about that. I mean, here, who wouldn't want this one?
I've never heard of sibling rivalry
before. Oh my goodness. Well, you've probably heard about it in human families, but certainly in the dog family.
As for a treatment for dogs, I've never heard of that one before.
This one is... jealousness, competitiveness, overbearing, and selfish. And I must tell you that I've had, when people have used them with their dogs, where 2 dogs couldn't even be in the same room together, within 2 or 3 days. Now, it might take 3 weeks or so, but dogs have been able to live together.
Excellent.
And there's been a lot of good feedback coming from folks who are using it. So I want people to know that there are products like these out there. There's an obsessive compulsive product and so forth. So the formulations are proprietary. It's different blends.
Sure.
Used regularly is certainly worth trying. So there's one before you give up on them when they're really at their end. And sometimes you have to use 2 together.
Sure.
So that's, so that's some stress busters for the holidays. Anything else we'd like to add at the end? Maybe some tips and hints. This went so fast. We have so many things we'd love to cover with you. Denise, anything else?
Well, I think we had mentioned a little bit earlier, just talking among ourselves, don't be afraid to have your dog have a break if you have a lot of company coming over. They don't have to be out the whole time to visit. You can wait until everybody's shown up and bring them out to have them come around and say hi to everybody and then let them go back to someplace quiet and calm. Sometimes playing a radio or a television gives them a quiet place to be. So
great tips.
Not every dog likes to party all the time.
Neither do all the people. Thanks again for joining us tonight. If you could put our final slide up, if you have any comments for us, if you'd like some topics you'd like us to cover, please certainly do so. We have some exciting topics coming up. Barn hunting as a dog sport. And all kinds of cool things. So please stay with us. We're on the second Saturday of every month.
Thursday
nights. Yeah, the Thursday night, second Thursday of every month, 7 to 7:30. So stay with us. We'll see you again. Thanks again. We'll